This guy had a situation going on. He said, I met a client in person, and after her appointment, I sent her a professional text asking how she felt. She responded positively and then unexpectedly invited me for a drink. We started as friends, but eventually we started dating despite my initial resistance. Interesting how in this scenario, the guy is the one that is being resistant, all right? And because of that, because he's showing indifference, because he's being resistant, he's not trying to force her into something, that's causing her to come to him and ask him out and take him on stuff. And what do I always tell you guys? If she's chasing you, she can't be replacing you. So anyway, he says, our relationship was blissful for 3 months, and she expressed how much she appreciated how well I treated her, especially after her past abusive relationships. So far, so good, but what happens next? However, suddenly, she seemed to change overnight. Her text messages became less frequent, devoid of the usual affectionate emojis, and she canceled our plans. I want to pause and say this, because I get a lot of messages from guys saying like, oh, things were going great, and all of a sudden things shifted. Now, I do believe that that can happen. Sometimes maybe she just all of a sudden decides she's not feeling it. What I typically find is in these scenarios, most men are leaving out key details that would better explain why a woman suddenly stopped being so available or start to lose interest. For example, a lot of guys will say, you know, we were texting back and forth and things are great. And then all of a sudden she just stopped texting me. What's going on? And I asked them, were you texting her like every day, all day? Well, yeah. That detail would help to help me better understand why she lost interest because you were too available. So when I hear these stories, I'm always like, I wish I could really talk with this person and get a better analytics on what was going on, because I could see like what kind of dates they were going on, how often they were talking to each other, what kind of conversations they were having. At any time, was he showing any jealousy towards her hanging out with any male friends or female friends? Like, all those details really paint a better picture for me of being able to analyze what was actually going on. So for now, we just take him at his word, which is like, everything was fine. And then all of a sudden, she was just texting less. But there's always, there's more often than not, there's usually, it's not just like, woman's interested, and then all of a sudden, boom, nosedive. Usually there are things that a guy can be unaware of that he's doing that are causing her to start losing interest. So if you can't figure that kind of stuff out, hit me up. I'll be happy to analyze your situation and help you figure this whole thing out. Anyway, he says, Saturday afternoon came the breakup text, which was long. But basically it said, quote, I have to break up with you because I can't get used to how good you are to me. It's really weird. This isn't the way guys normally treat me. I like you way too much, and relationships aren't supposed to be this smooth. You're freaking me out. I need a rougher relationship that I have to really work hard to make it feel worthwhile. I was stunned. I tried to explain that it's okay and how practically everyone wishes they had such a smooth relationship, but she didn't want to hear it. Her mind was made up, and that was it. I'm now confused and depressed. I wasn't even looking for a relationship in the first place, but she pursued me and then ended things because it was going too well. Does this mean that even a good relationship can be a problem? I'm unsure about what to think or how to move forward. Well, for starters, I'll say this, is that surprisingly, guy, this is a very common thing. Because just like I tell you guys, I said earlier how if you haven't had the practice of dating, then at the moment that women start to show you interest, it's going to be really, really weird for you because you're going to be thinking, oh my God, like a woman actually likes me. And that's fighting with your reality of, but women find me weird and strange. This can't be a thing, right? So this is the same thing that happens with women, whereby a woman will have this dating life, right? Where she's dated losers, jerks, people that have scammed her, people that have abused her, all sorts of things. And she's saying to herself, I just want a nice guy that's going to treat me well, blah, 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 blah. But at the point that a woman gets that, she realizes she doesn't actually have the skill set to deal with a guy that actually has emotional intelligence and has his stuff together and is not trying to fight her. And more importantly, she also realizes that a part of her is still connected to what makes her most comfortable. And what makes her most comfortable up to this point is being in relationships that have turmoil, because it's like a person, it's the personal hell theory. Even though she doesn't really like how she's treated in those scenarios, it's what she best knows, and it's what she knows how to operate best in. So you're going to come across women, guys, that they're spouting all this, I want a good guy bull crap, and I'm tired of these guys treat me wrong. And then you're going to be that guy, and she's going to think to herself one or two things. Either she's going to be thinking, this is too good to be true, I'm waiting for the other shoe to drop, and she's going to be constantly anxious. Or at the moment that you slip up at all, she's going to be doubly on you like, see, I knew it. I was just waiting for this to happen, blah, blah. And now anytime she looks at you, you could have made one or two mistakes and been like, hey, babe, my bad. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do X, Y, and Z. She's not going to believe your apology. And she's going to be thinking, I knew it. You're just like all the other guys overall. And you're going to be trying to fight to get back to a good place. And you're never going to, because she's going to always be thinking you're going to be this guy that keeps making mistakes or does me wrong. And it's a wrap, you know? And so these are scenarios where the worst thing you could do is try to fight against the narrative in her head. I have actually found, this is going to sound weird, I have found it is almost better to go along with her narrative so she can start looking at how dumb her narrative actually is. So for example, here, right? If this had been me, if she come to me and said, hey, so I got to break up with you. Okay, why is that? Because, you know, the way you treat me is just too nice. And, you know, I like it too much. And this relationship is too smooth and you're freaking me out. And I think I need something different, blah, 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 blah. My response had been like, okay, well, hey, you know, I really like you. I thought we had a good thing going. And all right, if you change your mind, let me know. But otherwise, best of luck to you. Do-do-do-do-do. And I'm out. Now, why would that be my response? That would be my response because it makes her, most guys are going to fight her on it. She's expecting a fight. She's expecting a guy to be like, but no, you got to stay around, blah, 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 blah. So when I'm the guy that does not do that, one, it's fighting against the narrative idea she had in her head of how this fight's going to go, right? And then the second thing is, she's going to now go back to her girlfriends, right? She's going to go to her girlfriends and say, well, me and so-and-so broke up. What? What? How? What? You broke up? Why? And she's going to be like, well, I told him that, you know, I just told him that he was too nice and he was treating me too good. And, you know, just the relationship was working too smooth. And I just need something that was a bit harder. And her girlfriends, if she has smart girlfriends, are going to be like, oh, okay. But isn't that like healthier? Isn't that what you wanted? And then what did he say? And then her response is going to be, well, you know what? He said, best of luck to me. And if I change my mind, then like, come back or let me know. And the girlfriend's gonna be like, oh, he actually responded to that pretty well. Like, is that the response you're expecting? I mean, I guess not really. Like, I thought he was gonna fight for me, blah, 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 blah. Wow, it sounds like he's a guy that doesn't really like a lot of drama. What? What do you mean? Well, just, I mean, you bring a lot of drama into your relationships. And so here's a guy that doesn't bring drama and you're the one bringing the drama. And now she has to sit with that and think about if that's the person she wants to be and if what she's doing is like really, really dumb. Because here's the thing also, you doing that, it shows her, as you should be showing the whole time, that you're ultimately indifferent. Like, you want what's going to work best for you, but you also want what's going to work best for her. If she decides, for whatever dumb reason she has, that you being calm, cool, and collected isn't what she wants, that's a decision she can make. But she has to explain it to everybody. Everybody across the board is going to be like, that's stupid. Like, what are you doing? And so by you not fighting on that scenario, it makes you look like the more mature one and the one that looks like he knows what he's doing. And I've dated women before where it's like, you know, I've had that same commentary of, oh, you're being too nice, blah, 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 blah. My response is always like, well, I can treat you worse if you want me to. Oh, no, don't do that. Why? Because that now sounds stupid. If I'm saying I can treat you worse, or I can do less for you, or I can stop calling you as much, like now she's thinking, oh, he actually is like cool with that, but that sounds dumb. Yeah, it sounds dumb when you as the guy are verbally saying back to her the dumb stuff that she's saying to you. Oh, you want to break up because it's too calm? Okay, cool. That's weird to me, but okay, whatever. Like, she has to reckon with that. And some women, honestly, you give them that speech, they might still be like, well, I want to go through the breakup, and they might go on and date other jerks and whatever like that. And unfortunately, it's sad that a lot of women don't learn until later on in their dating life, like in their 30s and 40s, like, oh, that guy that I dated that was nice to me back in the day, I should have gotten with him. Oh, he's married now. Oh, that sucks. But some women are gonna miss out on a good thing. And you know what? You have to be fine with that. But ideally, you have an abundance mindset to where if this scenario doesn't work out, you know there are other women out there. And I'm telling you guys, there are women out there that actually want calm, cool, collected, indifferent guys. That want introverted guys. That want guys that aren't trying to set up a fight all the time when they have a discussion or a disagreement. Like, those women out there exist, but there are a lot of women out here that unfortunately have learned bad habits or grew up in bad surroundings that are used to trauma and chaos being their normal mode of operandi. And you know what? If a woman tells you that, hey, this woman was upfront. She's basically saying, I need to date a guy that has as much trauma as I do. If you're not a guy that has a lot of trauma, great. Get rid of her. If you're a guy that has a lot of trauma, work on your trauma. Don't be stuck in your trauma and don't date women that also have trauma to bring to you. All right. But ultimately, this woman did this guy a favor. But yeah, if a woman comes to you with this stuff saying, hey, you're being too nice or this, this, and that, one, you can say, well, I can do less. And also you can just be like, okay, well, if you change your mind, do, and then see how she reacts. I'm telling you, if I have found agreeing with a woman who's breaking up with you, I have found that scenario results in more women trying to come back to you than if you're trying to fight them to stay. But then the question also is, but do you want to take a woman back like that? I have found typically my answer is no, but your results may vary.
You's a bad boy, but you can't stop, won't stop. Let's you are go. High earning, high value, high class man. You are high earning, high value, high class man. You are high earning, high value, high class man. You are high class man. You are high class man. You are high earning, high value, high class man.